It's been a while since I have done a video. It has been a while since I have made all you followers smile. It has been a while since I have talked about the Bears. It has been a while because I don't even... Anyways, what's up, everybody? How you doing? It's your boy with the small toy, Joey D. This is the Bears Beatdown. What's good, everybody? How you doing? I hope everybody is happy and healthy and, Grey Goose Free Virus. Or is that coronavirus? I'm sorry, guys. Corona. Anyways, guys, I just want to let you guys know that I'm sorry. I'm sorry I haven't been around for a while, maybe about 2-3 months. Had a little hiatus. My wife, God bless her, my wonderful, beautiful wife, who I love and adore, was going through some breast, but she's good right now. She's good, thank God. Everybody's okay. We're happy. We're healthy. But, you know, I can't stand the C. Serious. And I know that I have some followers, some people that watch the show, that the C has basically affected their family down in Texas, Chicago, the whole, wherever you're from. If you have or you know somebody that unfortunately has the C or going through the C, my heart goes out to you, and I'm going to pray for you and your family. So I love you guys. I've missed you, and all I want to do is kiss you. Anyways, how you doing? All right, let's get into it. The Bears season was done and over, and bada bing, bada boom. Maybe it's because my videos weren't that good. Maybe that's why they kind of did what they did last year. I don't know. But currently, honestly, guys, if you told me the beginning of the year last year that we are going to beat and take these, right, these horns, these Vikings, these horns go upside down all up in Chi-Town, all right, so... And then we're going to beat the Lions, we're going to tame the Lions twice, and we're going to go 4-2 in the division. I like those chances, I like those odds, right? You were all shaking our heads, I mean, that was beautiful, right? So if you go 4-2 in your division, you think that's going to be pretty good. Didn't happen. I think it all started, honestly, guys, about last year in the Raiders game. Remember the Raiders game? Akeem the Dream Hicks, he actually went out. He got hurt, that first series, that second series? So when Akeem Hicks went out, I literally saw or I felt that whole team, unfortunately, like deflate. You know, it's just, look, Akeem Hicks is an alpha dog in that locker room. His name should be Elmer because he's the glue, okay? So he keeps things together, keeps it tight. He's just a spark plug. So when he went down and he got injured, I think the mindset of these guys kind of were like, you know, hey, what do we do? What do we do? What do we do? You know? So I think that was actually crucial. Also, Kyle Long went down, guys, last year. Now, call what you want to. He retired. And I love Kyle Long, man. Kyle Long is always going to be a Bear, always going to be a Warrior for Chicago. And I love Kyle Long with all my heart. Never met the guy, but he seems like a good guy. Just saying. When Long went down, he was also that nasty guy on the offensive line that kept everybody together, too. So when he went down, it kind of messed the psyche up on the offense, too, a little bit. Just saying. So, you know, and then also the Saints game, guys. That's kind of one that really stings for me, right? No Drew Brees. Ho, hey. No Jared Cook. Hey, ho. No Alvin. Oh, hey. And they still freaking gave it to us. They still beat us. So right then and there, after we lost against the Saints, against all backups, I knew that we had a problem, all right? Everything wasn't peachy and rosy like we thought it was going to be in the offseason. Just saying. You know, all of these guys, basically, going into last season, they were here. They were, like, so high. Like, man, we got the Super Bowl. We're going to have the best defense, better than the 85 team. We got this. Don't even trip. And they didn't even step on the field once. So hopefully their mentality this year is, look, you always want to have that winning mentality, right? Anytime you step on the court, the field, whatever you do, be confident. Be confident in what you do. When you're going up in the bar, you're talking to a girl. Hey, like, hey, how you doing? Be confident. Just saying, all right? But anyways, guys, I just think that they thought they were already in the Super Bowl before the season started. Does that make any sense? Does the S know? Am I a chooch? Do I even know what I'm talking about here? But I think that that's kind of what happened a little bit last year. But we'll get into next year. This year coming up. Hold on, guys. The whole quarterback thing, you know, was it Mitch's fault? Was it Nagy's fault? You know what? Could have, should have, would have. It's done. It's over with, guys. We got to look, keep going, looking forward. Look, I love Coach Nagy. I love what he's done with the team. I love the atmosphere that he's built here and brought here in Chicago. And this is going to be your three for him, baby, and three for the love, all right? I'm just saying. So I think some big things are going to happen this year. Mitch, honestly, guys, oh, we saw good and bad Mitch, and that's really it. I mean, is there a middle Mitch? I don't know if there's a middle Mitch. Well, look, when Mitch is on fire, he's great. He's good. He was also banged up a little bit. Look, I'm not trying to make any excuses for Mitch. Is going to be Mitch our quarterback this year? Honestly, look, free agency is going to start, what, a day, 2 days, 3 days? Well, with the whole virus, who knows if they're going to, you know, push that back. People are probably signing on teams right now. I just heard that Ryan Tannehill just got re-signed, actually, on Tennessee. So that's a domino effect. We're going to see what's going to happen. But I know for a fact that Pace is definitely going to bring in, if not a starter instead of Mitch, I know he's going to bring in competition for Mitch. So we'll see what happens. And honestly, I have faith in Pace. I have faith in Nagy. And they actually brought together a rock star offensive staff this offseason with a new tight ends coach, a new offensive coordinator. I mean, they brought in some DeFilippo. I mean, he's a greaseball. I don't know if he's from Chicago or not, but he sounds like it because his last name ends in a vowel. So, but they brought the right staff. Even the offensive line coach, Coach Harry H, is gone, and they got Castillo, who's he's a bad mofo. All right, he don't take nothing. All right, so he's gonna get that offensive line in shape and be ready this year because we had way too many penalties on the offensive line this year, and there were holes in it. I mean, it wasn't good, guys. So, I'm not gonna make any excuses. Whoever our quarterback is, and that first game, week one, I'm going to support and ride out to the sunset because I know whoever is our starting quarterback this year is going to lead us to the promised land. Whoever it's going to be, if it's Tom Brady, God bless. All right. I mean, who knows? It might be Derek Carr. They're saying Andy Dalton. Who knows? Maybe they draft somebody. Or it could be Mitch, guys, and maybe Mitch gets his stuff straight and he does what he's got to do. I don't know yet, but we're going to find out here in a couple weeks. But on a positive note, we just re-signed Danny Trevathan, Granite 59. How you doing, bro? God bless. You're back. And you know what you are? You're a part of the Baba Yaga Boys. I don't know if you guys ever heard of the Baba Yaga Boys, but that's going to be Danny Trevathan, Khalil Mack. It's going to be, it's going to be Eddie Jackson and Akeem Hicks. The four of them. The four of them are going to make something. Don't copy me, guys. Don't copy me right now. This is me, Joey D, making this. The Baba Yaga Boys. Because I know for a fact those four cats are going to make offensive coordinators have a nightmares because they're the boogeyman, all right? Our guys right there who I just named, our defense is going to be called the Baba Yaga Boys because they're the boogeyman because they're going to be putting fear in offenses. You heard it here first, guys. These guys are going to be hungry and they're going to want to eat and they're going to want to feast on these offenses because remember this, guys, this is year two. Year two for Chuck Pagano's defense and you know they're only going to get better. They're going to gel and they're going to mold and they're going to be more aggressive, and they're going to get at it. Trust me, as long as, knock on wood, this is wood underneath there, right? Hey, that's what you tell the girl. Hey, I got wood. Anyways, guys, knock on wood, everybody's healthy. This defense is going to be hungrier than ever before, guys. We're going to be seeing some crazy things in Chicago this year. Chi-Town for life, guys, just saying. We're obviously going to need some O-line help. Maybe two new starters on the offensive line you're going to see this offseason. Two. We need it. I'm just saying, all right? Charles Leno Jr., he seems like a good guy, all right? He seems like good, but he kind of regressed this year. I don't know what it is. Maybe he changed something up in his diet. I don't know what it is, but we're definitely going to see two new starters on the offensive line this year. We're going to need, obviously, a tight end. Or two, I don't know if we're going to go after Eric Ebron or draft the kid from Purdue or Notre Dame, but we're definitely going to get some new guys, some new tight end because we need it. Honestly, here, I'm not trying to stick up for Mitch or the offense, but if we had a tight end or handled some business with a tight end, I think our record would be better than it really was because in Matt Nagy's offense, you need a tight end. You need a tight end to handle some business and get down like James Brown. You know what I mean, Jelly Bean? So we need that for sure. And honestly, I love our wide receivers. We have a really good wide receivers coach. The guy's actually pretty jacked. He's got some guns, all right? Probably bigger than mine. Yeah, I got some super soakers. Anyways, but he
the wide receivers, I just hope we, you know, re-sign Allen Robinson, give him an extension, because I love A-Rob. Honestly, A-Rob is a beast. He's an alpha dog. Man, all those contested catches. He's got good hands, too. He's got the Elmer hands, too, with the glue, because he just goes up there, grabs the ball, he says, how you doing? So, I love Allen Robinson. I think Anthony Miller, if he's healthy, he's going to be tearing the club up this year. We have Ridley. We also have Wims. So with those four guys, I mean, those are solid guys, to be honest with you. And they're probably going to draft a young kid, maybe get a veteran of wide receiver free agent, maybe. But I'm telling you, our wide receivers are going to be dope this year and sick. We just got to have the right guy, get him the right ball. You know what I mean? That's all it means. Just saying. All right, guys. So I think our D-line, though, needs some help, though. I don't know what's going to happen with Leonard Floyd. Should he stay or should he go? But we need more pass rush presence. Because, look, Max on one side, on the other side, he's going to need some help. I'm just saying. Now, Akeem Hicks, if he's healthy, that's going to help out Mac, too. But you know what, though? It's going to be a long season. They just signed that CBA, NTB, LOL, OMG. So they just signed the collective bargaining agreement. So I think there's going to be 17 games this – well, there's going to be 17 games next season. I'm sorry. But they're going to have two extra playoff teams on each, you know, conference, you know, NFC and AFC. So that means the Bears could get in there. But you don't want these guys, basically, you know, you want to rotate them to keep them fresh for the playoffs, because when they get in the playoffs, they're burnt, they're spent, you know. So we need some more pass rush help. And there's a lot of guys out there. I'm not going to get into it today who I want or who we're going to get. And I'm sorry I'm late to the game, literally. But I've gone through some stuff here at the house with the wife, the family. So, but my mind's back. My head's on right. Because it was off the swivel lately. It was like, woo. So, anyways, guys, I got my mind right. I'm here. I missed you guys. I love you. Going back, though, we also need the secondary. Obviously, we got we cut Prince, and I like Prince. Prince was a really good guy. I wish Prince the best. All of these guys, honestly, I'm not going to throw anybody under the bus, any player, because they all have families. They might have kids, and you don't want anybody to lose their job. They're all professionals. So I wish anybody that was a Bear this year, Taylor Gabriel, he's not with us anymore. I wish all these guys the best. And honestly, happiness and healthiness. That's what I wish for everybody. That's what I wish for you guys, too. Except Aaron Rodgers. That guy, oh, God. Anyways, so we probably need, I don't know if we're going to re-sign, I heard they're saying that he might re-sign with us. God bless. We obviously need another starting cornerback. So we'll see what happens. But we definitely need some secondary help. I love Eddie Jackson. They re-signed Eddie Jackson this year. Eddie Jackson's sick. We had, obviously, Kyle Fuller. So those are two key components on our defense, which I love. So anyways, guys, I just want to let you know that we will win this year. We are going to win this year. I'm confident. I believe in my team. And if you don't believe in your team, hey, God bless. It's okay. But, baby, look, you're in Bears country. This is Chicago Bears. CB to the world, blow up, everybody. And I love the Bears. I'm always going to love the Bears. And think about it. Honestly, there's 32 teams in the NFL, right? And only one of them won. So if you're not first, you're last, right? So I don't care what you Packer fans say, okay, you Lions fans say, or you Vikings fans say. None of you guys won a Super Bowl, and neither did we. And I'm not saying we did, but I'm just saying, we're all at the level playing field. We're all 0-0 right now. We'll see what happens. But I have faith in my team. I have faith in Pace, and I'm a Chicago Bears fan till the day that I die, baby. Just saying. So we got some big things coming up this year. I'll probably do another video maybe next week or 2 weeks. You're going to see my ugly mug more often now, and I'm going to try to get it together, guys. I really am. I would just love, though. Hey, Tariq, how you doing? You look a little stale. How you been? You haven't moved in a while. I think he's getting old on me. He's getting some gray hair, too. Anyways, I love you, Tariq. You're going to do good this year. He still doesn't talk to me at all, unless he wants me to tuck him in, maybe, and I put a blanket over him. Anyways, guys, I'm going to try to maybe get a coach on here, a player. If you guys know anybody or wants to be on the show with me, that would be amazing, and I would appreciate it. But anyways, guys, I'm Joey D, and I've missed you, and all I want to do is kiss you, or just hug you, or give you a pound anyways. But this is the Bears Beatdown, and I'm back, baby. Peace out.